哇，今天真的是全部朋友都回来了，全部小朋友都回来了。好，来，我们先开始我们的 praise and worship。来，第一首歌是什么歌？谁知道？
Welcome to church。
对 ，Welcome to church。来，你们唱得很棒 ，OK， 来，我们下一首歌，下一首歌，我们要有请我们的小雨老师。来，下一首歌是《Thank You God》。好，这个有一点小动作，小朋友们，来，你们看着老师跟着我做好不好 ？OK， 来，你们看到那个歌词对不对？来 ，Thank You God for this wonderful world。OK， wonderful 啊，这个 word for the sun， 我们的 sun 是圆圆的，有没有圆？啊、OK， 对了 ，OK， blue blue sky and the blue blue sky， 散了过后在上面就 blue blue sky， OK， 然后 for the birds 就这么样，手在这边了，就从这边过来，这个是 grass and the grass and the flower， flower 是短的，然后 tree 是高的，长的 ，OK， 然后还有一个是 bright little butterfly， 记得吗？记得吗？OK， 我们 try，OK，、okay? 来，我们请小雨老师，啊，大家都不是那么熟悉，那我们就先来一个慢的版本。挑战自己。 快一点点，可以吗？小朋友可以吗？来，我们来一个快一点点的，好不好？来，老师。有没有举手？哦，哎呀，我不理了，要快一点，更快一点 ，OK？ 好，来。接下来这首歌也是请小雨老师帮我们弹奏的，这下一首歌是耶稣爱我， OK， 好，也有他的动作，小朋友们看着老师，跟老师一起做， OK， 耶稣也可以，耶稣爱我，我也爱你，就是这么简单， OK， 动动手动动脚的哈，那个脚要拿出来，简单好不好？OK， 再来一次，我们再唱一次啊！耶稣爱我，我也爱你，就是这么简单。耶稣爱我，我也爱你，就是这么简单。来了，哦，就是这么简单，嘿，哦。再读一遍。谁爱你们最多？谁知道？谁知道？有没有人知道？谁爱你？哦，耶稣是爱我，大家都说耶稣爱我，来大大声的来，耶稣爱我，耶稣也爱你 ，OK？ 耶稣爱我，耶稣也爱你。来，我们下一首歌，谢谢小雨老师。好，现在这一首歌是，哦，等一等。这个走走走呢，我们有点小道具的，来，我们小朋友们来过来跟安哥买个奶，这一个摇摇的那个 ring， 还有一个 flag，
一个手拿 flag， 一个手拿铃，
对，一个 flag 和一个铃，不要拿少了，小朋友们。还有一个零，还有一个零，去哪的一个零？好，小朋友们 ，OK。 OK， 爸爸妈妈，这个铃啊、这个 flag 可能是指留给预备了给小朋友。爸爸妈妈如果要的话，可以拿一个铃在手上，陪着我们一起 marching 的下。还有谁没有？
谢谢。
来，小爸爸妈妈可以拿一个 ring， 如果你们要的话。来，没有拿到棋子的不要紧，就两手上拿两个这个零零就好了。手上拿两个零零就好了。好，OK， 这一个呢，今天动作很多，对不对？大家这个 MCO 的时候全部在家的哦，没有什么运动了。今天我们就来一个大运动，要 marching marching 的哈，大家哈。好，好了没有？准备好了没有？哦，好，好 ，OK， 来，我们可以开始了。我们唱的歌，我们要在世上做盐做光 ，OK， 不从恶人的计谋。小朋友要记得哈、啊，如果不知道什么来的，回家问爸爸妈妈，这个是什么来的？为什么叫我做盐的？好好，现在你们可以把这个零零还回来这个 box 这边，谢谢你们。这个棋子你们在桌这就好了。
可以带回家。
啊，可以带回家。
棋子可以带回家，
棋子可以带回家。好。好。 来，我们接下来这一首歌是，如果你想知道。
如果你想知道爱在哪里，爱就在你我的周围。如果你想知道爱在哪里，爱就在每个笑脸上。想知道爱在哪里，爱就在成长生命中。如果你想知道爱在哪里，爱就在父母的心里。
现在是我们准备我们的心静下来，现在是A Gift to You， 接下来这首歌了，我们就会做一个奉献的时间。好。
Lord, if we could, we would fill our hands with all the wonderful things you give us. Then we'd lift them up and give them back to you. you give us. Then we lift them up and give them back to you.
你们的手，谢谢你们，爸爸妈妈也如果碰了钱，请你们到麦哥那边拿来一个 sanitizer。谁还没有 sanitizer 的，请你们立马拿一些 sanitizer， 谢谢你们。我们请麦哥为我们做一个奉献的祷告。
大家，我们要做个奉献祷告好吗？很开心哦，今天看到这么多人回来。我也是 MCO 过后哦，六个月后回来的第一次，所以我觉得很开心，看到所有的爸爸妈妈还有小朋友们回来我们的教会。OK， 来，我要大家闭上眼睛，合上你们的手，来，我们做一个奉献祷告好吗？来，专心。OK， 亲爱的天父。你是我们的你是我们的唯一的神，我们能够依靠的神。我们要感谢你哦，能够保守我们 PCW 每一个家庭、每个成员、每个爸爸妈妈、小朋友，特别是要上班的爸爸妈妈，要保守他们，还有要上学的小朋友，要保守他们，给他们有健康的身体，有更好的免疫力，可以抵抗所有的病菌。天父啊，我们要求你继续的保守我们每个家庭，给我们每个家庭有足够的供应，我们每个家庭所需的。谢谢你天父，我们真的要感谢你，奉主耶稣名祷告， Amen。 谢谢大家。接下来时间我们要交给等一下，我们先读一下经文哦。来，大家跟我一起读经文。爱里没有惧怕，相反，完美的爱能除去惧怕，因为惧怕带有惩罚，而那惧怕的在爱里没有得以完全。我们爱是因为他先爱了我们。然后我们读英文版哦。There is no fear in love, but perfect love drives out fear, because
fear has to do with punishment.
The one who fears is not made perfect in love. We love because he first loved us. 好，谢谢大家。现在的时间我们要交给 Tony 老师。耶、
yeah! ！Hello， 大家好。今天是我第一次做老师，谢谢感谢神，那也是我第一次 在这么多人面前，还有家长面前、小孩子面前，说爱是什么？约翰老师叫我上台 ，OK。哇 ，OK。那上个礼拜呢，玉恒老师有说爱是不喜欢什么，对不对？那今天，这是我儿子，那今天我会说，他叫我把这个拿掉，其实我不想拿掉，那你们才不认得我。OK， next slide please。那爱是什么呢？今天我要向大家说的是，在根据哥林多前书第十三章四到八节，爱是恒久忍耐，又有恩慈；爱是不嫉妒，不自夸，不张狂。那今天我的主题是爱是不嫉妒。那什么是嫉妒呢 ？Next， 那什么是嫉妒 ？What is jealous？ 谁知道什么是嫉妒？我给个例子，Aiden， 我今天给你喝维他金，我没有给弟弟，那弟弟会嫉妒吗？会不会？一定会，对不对？这时常发生在我看每个家庭，你给弟弟你不给哥哥，或者你给哥哥你不给弟弟，你给姐姐不给妹妹，你给妹妹不给姐姐，都常会发生这个事情，对不对？然后他就会吵，那个没有得到的就会吵，就会要求。但是这个东西，今天我等下会让你们看一段短片，就是这个短片这个故事是告诉我们，关于 Joseph 的约瑟。那谁是约瑟呢？谁是 Joseph？ Joseph 其实是 Jacob 的儿子。那谁是 Jacob 呢？这个故事里面没说到谁是 Jacob， 但是会告诉你。对了 ，Jacob 是 Joseph 的爸爸。对了，那这个故事里面呢，会告诉你，Joseph 怎样被他的哥哥害，就因为这个妒忌心。他如何被害，然后他被他害了之后，被他的哥哥们害了之后，这 Joseph 又会变成怎样？那这个故事大概有12分钟，你们小孩子们还有家长们看了之后，等下我会发问几个问题，然后让大家更加能够了解这个妒忌，会我们带来什么。然后从那边我们还需要给一点小小的那个 reward， 就是那个就是我孩子他知道我要给什么 reward， 就是那些能够回答问题的，我有几个问题能够回答的，我给他维他金，好不好？让我们 next， 我们就去啊，这个就是啊，我们去看影片了。好，
Joseph was one of the 12 sons of a man named Jacob in Canaan. He had 10 elder brothers and one younger brother. Joseph's mother had died when she gave birth to his younger brother. Joseph and his brothers helped their father in the field. They also herded the sheep. Joseph was the favorite child of Jacob since he was young and innocent. Jacob spent a lot of time with Joseph. This made the brothers very jealous. On his 17th birthday, Jacob gifted Joseph a beautiful coat that had all the colors of the rainbow on it. Joseph was very happy, but his brothers were not. They were now even more jealous. They felt that their father did not appreciate all the hard work they were doing for him. One night, Joseph had a strange dream. He was very excited, and he went to his brothers who were herding the sheep. Hey, Simeon, I had a very strange dream yesterday night. You should hear this.
Oh, look, Daddy's little pet had a dream. Don't waste my time, boy. I have a lot of work to do. I can't sit and dream all day like you.
No, listen, in my dream, we were all tying up sheaves in the field. All of a sudden, my sheaf stood upright while your sheaves bowed down to mine. Simeon looked scornfully at Joseph and then at his brothers.
Oh, he isn't just stupid. He thinks even we're stupid.
No, this was my dream. And listen, in another dream, the sun, the moon, and the stars were all bowing down to me. That was so beautiful.
So now you want us to bow down to you, huh? Run away before we beat you with this stick.
One day, Jacob sent Joseph to check on his brothers who were resting on the hillside. They were actually talking about Joseph and how irritating he was. When they saw Joseph running to them from a distance, they got so angry that they actually planned to kill him. Reuben, the eldest brother, felt strongly against this, but he knew that his brothers were too angry to listen to him.
Let's kill this irritating boy and we don't have to worry about him ever again. What do you think, my brothers? Come on, Simeon. We're his brothers. We can't just kill him. We'll just throw him into this deserted well and decide what to do with him later. That's a good idea.
As Joseph came to where their brothers were resting, Simeon and Reuben held him while another brother took off his colorful coat. Then they threw him into the well. The brothers returned home, leaving Joseph all alone in the well. Reuben was sad at what happened. He planned to come around later and rescue Jacob. Just then, they saw a group of merchants were passing by. They were from Egypt and were returning after selling their merchandise. Then Levi, another brother, had an idea.
Why don't we sell Joseph to these Egyptian merchants? That way we can get rid of him once and for all without killing him. That's a great idea, Levi. Let's do it. Call those merchants here. We'll also have some money on our hands. Where is Reuben? Will he agree with this? He went to pick up something. Don't worry, he'll agree with us.
The brothers tied Joseph's hands behind his back and sold their little brother to the merchants for 20 silver coins. When Reuben came back, he was terrified to hear what his brothers had done, but he could not say anything. The brothers then took Jacob's coat and sprinkled it with the blood of a goat. The brothers went back to Jacob and told him that Joseph had been captured by a wild animal. Jacob burst out crying, and he was deeply saddened for his favorite son's loss. Joseph was sold to a very rich Egyptian named Potiphar. He was an assistant to the Pharaoh. Joseph was very intelligent and hardworking. He was also very handsome. Potiphar was very pleased with Jacob and put him in charge of all his properties. Unfortunately, Potiphar's wife one day had an unnecessary argument with Joseph. Since she was upset with him, she told lies about Joseph to her husband. Potiphar was angry with Joseph and he sent him to jail. When in jail, Joseph overheard two prisoners talking to each other. One prisoner was a servant to the Pharaoh, and the other was a baker.
I had the strangest dream yesterday night. I wish I could make some sense of it.
My dreams are even more weird than yours.
Maybe I can help you. I can help you understand your dreams.
Ha ha! You're just a boy. How are you going to understand my dreams?
I do not interpret them. My God helps me. I will try to tell you what they mean. My God surely has a message for you. So the servant described his dream to Joseph. Joseph listened to him carefully and told the servant that his dream meant he would be released from prison in 3 days and he would be taken back by the Pharaoh as his servant. Joseph asked the servant to remember him when meeting the Pharaoh and ask that he be released. 3 days later, the servant was released, just like Joseph had predicted. But when he returned to the prison, he forgot all about Joseph. And because of this, Joseph remained in prison for 2 long years. One night, the Pharaoh had a strange dream and could not sleep. The next morning, he called all his wise men, ministers, and counselors and described his dream to them. Nobody had an answer to what it could mean. When the servant, who was in jail with Joseph, heard about this, he suddenly remembered his promise. He ran to the Pharaoh and told him about the prisoner who could interpret dreams. The Pharaoh immediately summoned Joseph.
So,
My servant says you can interpret dreams. He tells me you are extremely gifted. I am not capable of such things, Your Majesty. My God works through me. He can give you the meaning of your dreams. Describe your dream to me. Very well. In my dream, I saw 7 fat cows eating grass in a field. Then 7 thin, ugly cows rose up from the River Nile and swallowed the 7 fat cows. What does this mean? Joseph listened to the Pharaoh and then closed his eyes for some time. He walked across the room and came back to the Pharaoh. My lord, this dream you just described is very symbolic. It is a message from God. God is telling you that a great famine is coming. It will last for 7 years. There will be no food to grow, no rains. A lot of people will starve and die. Oh, that is terrible news. We are all doomed then. Wait, my lord, I am not finished yet. The dream came to you as a warning from God to prepare for the famine. There will be 7 years of plenty before the famine. So you can store up on food grains and livestock and other supplies during this period. You must make the most of this chance to produce excess food so that you can store it for later. Oh, you are right. Thank God I found you. This is great news. We will be prepared for the famine. We will produce plenty of food and build up storages for the difficult times. Thank you, Joseph. You are the most wise man in the kingdom. I am appointing you in charge of overseeing this work. Your Majesty, the honor is truly mine. These are not my powers. God speaks through me. I am simply conveying his message to you. Joseph helped the king to grow extra food grains and build storages during the 7 years of plenty so that people would not starve during the 7-year famine. He was also very popular among the people and earned their love and respect. The 7 years of plenty had passed by. The famine started. In the places around Egypt, animals were dying, lakes and rivers dried up, and people were starving to death. The people of Egypt had plenty to eat and drink because of the work done by the Pharaoh with Joseph. They had so much grain stored up that they were selling whatever was left to the people outside of Egypt who were starving. Jacob and his sons were struck by the famine as well. Their crops had all failed and their sheep had died one by one until nothing was left. They had heard of the Egyptian Pharaoh who was selling food grains to people outside of Egypt. So Jacob sent his 10 sons to Egypt to get food for the family. Benjamin, the youngest son, stayed back with Jacob. When the brothers reached the palace of the Pharaoh where the food grains were being distributed, they saw a royally dressed man sitting on a high chair and supervising the distribution of the food. They approached him. It was actually Joseph. But they did not recognize him since it had been 10 years since they had seen him. But Joseph recognized his brothers. He realized that they did not know it was him, and he kept quiet. His brothers greeted him and then bowed down in front of him, just like the dream he had had when he was a boy. Where have you come from?
We are from a faraway land called Canaan. The famine has struck us badly. We are a family of 12, and we have come to buy some food grains. Our father is waiting for us at home.
I do not believe you. You look like spies. Are you here to bring harm to our people?
No, my lord. We're not spies. We're just hungry travelers in search of food. Please give us some food grains, and we will be on our way home to our father. Please help us.
Okay. Get up. I will sell you my grains. But you must bring your youngest brother and father when you come next time.
Thank you, my lord. We will do that.
The next time, Jacob and Benjamin went with the other brothers to Egypt to meet the Pharaoh. Joseph was overjoyed to see his father and little brother. After some time, Joseph revealed himself to them. Reuben, I am the brother you sold off to the Egyptians.
Oh, my brother, it's really you. What have I done?
Do not fear me. I hold no anger against you. Because of you, I was able to meet great people and be of service to these people. I was able to help feed them in the time of starvation. I have earned their love and respect, all because of you. I want all of you to come here in Egypt and live with me. Jacob could not believe that his darling son was alive after all these years. He ran to him and hugged him, while his brothers bowed down to him, just as he had dreamt many, many years ago.
OK， 这个影片有一点长哦，但是这个影片有带出一些信息给我们，就是妒忌，然后把他给卖了，然后他又原谅了他哥哥，对不对？那我现在问几个问题哦，关于这个故事的，看谁能够回答。OK， 这里有几个，什么是妒忌呢？为什么约瑟就是 Joseph 的哥哥妒忌 Joseph 呢？为什么他妒忌他？谁知道？好，你说。
因为他们看到 Joseph 有一个很漂亮的外套，所以他们就很妒忌。
对了，他说因为 Joseph 的爸爸给了他那个很漂亮的外套，然后他们就他的哥哥们就妒忌 Joseph。 对，这是对的。然后这个你想怎么样？我太太呢？OK，来去。 OK，等一下我啊，就是维他金耶、yeah、Joseph 的爸爸就是 Jacob 呢，其实他是比较疼爱 Joseph， 那是对的。然后我不是说他对，我不是说他爸爸对，但是说在故事里面这是对的。那他给了他一件那个彩衣，对不对？就像这件啊，我今天特地穿的这样，像 rainbow 嘛，他刚才说 rainbow， 那就是给了他彩衣，他不给其他的兄弟。那你们如果有注意听的话，其实他有多少个兄弟呢？十二个兄弟，对不对？他排第几 ？Joseph 排第几？
第十一。
哇，我没有给他答案，虽然他是我孩子，但是我没有给他答案哦。所以等一下你拿一罐那个维他金。那还有一些问题在这电话里面。 OK， 刚才你们有看到 Joseph 的哥哥把 Joseph 丢进什么地方啊？好 Well， 丢进一个井里面，对不对？对了，答对了，耶、yeah ！这证明你有看。然后再问你们一个问题，就是很重要的 ，Joseph， 发了几个梦？一个而已吗 ？Joseph 发了几个梦 ？Devon， 两个梦，对，就是那么简单。下来的题目就难一点，他发的那两个梦到底说些什么呢？第一个梦说什么 ？OK， 第一个梦其实他们说的就是，他梦到他们兄弟做的那个叫什么道，道河道，对不对？道河和道。向着他的道磕头敬拜，对，这是第一个。他把这个事情告诉了给他的哥哥，就是说他哥哥 他们大家一起都做同样的东西，但是他的哥哥做的东西向着他的东西敬拜，这是第一个梦。那第二个梦呢，就是什么？第二个梦比较简单，有关系到星星太阳的。嗯，对，也是一样的，星星太阳月亮向着他敬拜，这是他所发的两个梦。 OK， 那维他金还是一样是一个。 OK OK， 好，那接下来当你们妒忌别人的时候，你就很难去用那个爱心去对待他们。那你刚才看到 Joseph 其实他被害了之后，到最后他还是原谅，选择原谅他的哥哥们，对不对？他还叫他的哥哥跟父亲们，他的家人全部到埃及去跟他一起生活，对不对？就是说他已经宽恕了他的哥哥们，虽然他的哥哥们妒忌他，把他给害了，把他给卖了，但是他还是选择宽恕。所以这个就是神要我们体会跟知道的，让你们大家都有这个心去宽恕和原谅别人。当别人妒忌你的时候，你应该不要，就是说不要去怪他们，不要去生气他们。然后你们必须要，如果他们有害你或者是怎样对你不好的话，你们要用一颗宽恕的心去对待他们，这是符合神的旨意的。这就是神要我们知道，就算我们经历这样的困难，然后也要用爱心去对待这些妒忌你的人或者是对你不好的人。这是一个很重要的一个信息。哦，希望你们大家，虽然我说的可能有点深，就好像刚才安迪说的，唱歌的时候不知道那个是什么意思的话，我不知道我刚才安格托尼刚才说的什么意思的话，你们回去问你的爸爸妈妈。OK， 或者问传道哈。OK，next、okay, slide please。那我们说了很久 ，Joseph。那到底是哪一个是 Joseph 呢？我刚才说的 Joseph 到底是哪一个？这里也是左，到底是左边的那个 Joseph 还是右边的那个 Joseph？ 你知道吗？这里也有一个安哥叫 Joseph， 就在后面那个。所以我们刚才故事里面的 Joseph 是那个哈，就是右边，我的右边的那个。但是我相信我们这个 Joseph 的这个爸爸就是爸爸，也是一个相当非常棒的一个爸爸哈。他也是一个完全没有妒忌心，然后会以爱去爱人的一个爸爸哈。OK， next， 让我的分享就到这里。我用一个简单的一个祷告来结束。然后结束了之后呢，我太太会教你们小孩子一个简单的一个手工，然后希望等一下我就 pass 给他。好，那我做一个简单的祷告。亲爱的天父，谢谢你今天让我们知道妒忌的可怕。那我希望求你让我们能够除去这个妒忌心，我们的小孩子们能够除去这个妒忌心，然后学会怎样以爱去对待别人，怎样去宽恕别人，然后希望他们能够健康的成长长大。奉耶稣基督的名求，阿们。好，那我 pass 给我的太太 Sabrina。
OK， 小朋友们，刚才你们有看到那个 Joseph， 他有一件七彩的那个衣服，所以我们今天的手工呢，我们会要帮他做上那一个衣服。这个是我做了过后的， OK， 这个呢是还没有做的，所以小朋友们要填上颜色，然后把他的衣服弄得很七彩。你们可以自己用你们自己的那个 idea 来去做。做好的人呢，可以就是如果今天做不完，你们可以回到家的时候呢，叫爸爸妈妈你们做好了，就snap 那个 photo， 然后放在我们的那个 PCW 的那个 WhatsApp 里面。然后有教的小朋友会有一支七彩的那个笔给你们 ，OK？ 好，现在我们到后面去做，小朋友可以到后面去，后面有那一些材料可以给你们做。
想知道爱在哪里，爱就在你我的周围。如果你想知道爱在哪里，爱就在每个笑脸上。
爱在哪里，爱在哪里，爱就在你爱自己。爱错了吗，
想知道爱在哪里，爱就在成长生命中。如果你想知道爱在哪里，爱就在父母的心里。